If your teacher requires you to participate in class using the iClicker Reef, you will first need to sign up for an account online. To sign up, go to iClicker.com, then look for the link to create an account. Click on the link and follow the prompts. As of the day this video was created, this is how the website looks like through a desktop browser. Click on Create an Account. Click on Student. Type your school name in the search box. If you type Nichols, Nichols State University should appear below it. Click on it. Click on Next. Fill in the required information. Please use your official university email address. Click on the Create Account button at the bottom of the page. The Create Account button becomes clickable when you have filled in all the required information. You can sign up for a student account from an app on your phone or tablet. Go to your App Store, search for and download the iClicker Reef app. Open the app and follow the sign up link. Here's the sign up link. Here's how to sign up for a course so that you can participate using iClicker Reef. You must already have an iClicker Reef account and logged into it. If you've logged out and need to log back in, go to iClicker.com. Here's what the website looks like as of the time this video was created. Look for the sign-in link. Here it is. Click on it. Once you're logged in, you will see a list of courses that you have signed up for. To add a course to the list, click on the plus symbol on the upper right-hand corner. Click on your school name if you see it. Otherwise, search for it by entering part of the name in the search box. Here's what happens when Nichols State University is selected as the institution. You can type part of the name of the course or your instructor's name in the search box. For example, if you type BIOL in the search box, you will see a list of biology courses at Nichols State University. If you type LO, you will see a list of courses for which the instructor is named low. Click the course that you want to sign up for. For example, if you want to sign up for Camp 304 Spring 2021, click here. You will be asked to confirm that you want to sign up for a course. Do this by clicking on Add This Course. You will then see an updated list of courses that you have signed up for. Here's the course I just added. If you change your mind, you can delete the course by clicking on the three dots, then click on Delete. You can also sign up for a course using the mobile app. The procedures are essentially the same. With the app, you can delete a course by swiping left. To be able to participate in iClicker polls through Reef, you need to subscribe to the service. The subscription fee covers access to all courses. You don't need to pay a separate fee for each course. You get a free 2-week trial, and you can renew for durations ranging from 6 months to 4 years. To extend your subscription, you must first log into your account at iClicker.com or through your mobile app. Click the hamburger icon on the top left corner of your screen. The hamburger icon looks like three horizontal lines. Clicking on it brings up the menu of things that you can do. This is the menu that comes up. Click on Subscriptions. Then click on Polling. Click on Purchase Subscription to pay by credit card. If you have an access code, click on Enter Access Code instead. As of the time this video was made, this option is not available through the mobile app. You have to log in through an internet browser if you want to redeem an access code. Click on your desired duration for your subscription. It can be as short as 6 months or as long as 4 years. Enter your credit card information. Then scroll to the bottom and click on Review and Confirm. The remaining step should be self-explanatory. To participate in iClicker polls using Reef, Log into your iClicker Reef account and click on the course that is scheduled to be in session. As soon as your teacher starts an iClicker session, you will get a message that the teacher has started class. Click on the Join button. You will then get a message that says you are checked in. When your teacher asks a multiple choice question, respond by clicking on one of the choices, A, B, C, D, or E, that appear at the bottom of the screen. In the example shown here, C has been picked as the answer. You can click on another letter if you change your mind. The last answer you submitted is the one that counts. Your screen updates when your answer is received, when the teacher ends the poll, and when the teacher marks the correct answer. When a numeric response is expected, the bottom of your screen shows something like this. Type your answer in the response box. You will only be allowed to type the numbers 0 through 9, the minus sign, a decimal point, a caret, and the letter E. For example, 1.6 times 10 to the negative 9 should be entered as 1.6 E minus 9. 10 to the 5th should be entered as 1 E5 or 10 caret 5. Once you type something in the response box, the Send Answer button becomes clickable. Click on it to submit your answer. For as long as the teacher hasn't ended the poll, you can submit another answer. Only your last answer counts. Your screen updates when your answer is received, when the teacher ends the poll, and when the teacher marks the correct answers. When the expected response is a short answer, the bottom of your screen shows something like this. Type your answer in the response box. You can enter up to 140 characters. Once you type something in the response box, the Send Answer button becomes clickable. Click on it to submit your answer. For as long as the teacher hasn't ended the poll, you can submit another answer. Only your last answer counts. Your screen updates when your answer is received, when the teacher ends the poll, and when the teacher marks the correct answers.